My first tattoo was this guy right here, right on my ribs. I was 15 years old.
Man, I don't even know if I should be saying this. Who cares? I'm Dirty Dom. Legally, I wasn't allowed to go to a tattoo shop and get it done. So my dad, being the dad that he is, said, you know what? Let me make a phone call. Our guy, I won't say his name so he doesn't get in trouble. He ended up coming down to our house, setting up his table in our garage, and he tattooed me for about 3.5 hours. I remember my dad was super proud. He was very excited. I was super excited. I was originally gonna get it like right here on my back. And I remember he was like, nah, he goes, and I quote, he said, don't be a b-. He said, get it where it hurts the most, on your ribs. I said, I'm gonna get it on my ribs. There's a specific picture of me. As soon as he starts off, my eyes instantly just go big. And I'm biting down on this neck pillow for the whole 3.5 hours. No break, just straight 3.5 hours biting into this pillow. So Psalm 27:3, though an army may encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war may rise against me, in this I will be confident. Basically, when I was 15, I always thought that it was gonna be me against the world, and there was nothing that could stop me. And I always knew if God was on my side, no one can be against me. So it was just something that I thought was significant, and it is significant to me still at this time. So it's cool to still have it there and remind me during the hard times that like I still got it. The next year, I don't know what it was, but I was like, you know what? I need a half sleeve. And that's when I ended up getting this bad boy right here, which is French Polynesian from my mom's side, who my great grandfather was French Polynesian, came from France. I don't know if you can see it, but the red outlining, if I like put my arm straight, the red outlining makes a cross. It's kind of hidden in there, but if you can see it, if you see it, you see it. If you don't, sucks to suck. This one was also very painful, but this one I was able to cheat a little bit because after I got my ribs done, my dad goes, hey, there's numbing cream that you can use. And I was like, why are you telling me this now? So I ended up using a little bit of this one. I think it was like three sessions. I did like 3, 4.5, 5 hour sessions before he finally finished it up. I was old enough then to go to the shop, so I was good. I was good to go. This one's like fully filled in, and I think this one has to be my biggest one because it like wraps around back here as well. So with this guy, I told him I wanted like a Aztec calendar, but not traditional, because you see, like my dad had on his mask, the back of his mask, he had the Aztec calendar, and it's like the sun with the tongue sticking out. I wanted mine to be a little bit more like gritty, a little bit darker. So I ended up doing this, like the skull in there, almost like a chief. 99% of the tattoos on my arms have significance and have some sort of meaning. The ones that are for me are on my legs. Those are kind of just like random ones that I decided to do for myself to have some fun. I have Bela Lugosi Dracula. I have Frankenstein, Wolfman, and then the creature from the Black Lagoon. I feel like I hung out with my grandparents a lot, and my grandparents loved like those old classic ones. I think the best part about it is I watched all those movies in Spanish. So like they were all like dubbed and in black and white, and I still like really like them. Hell, even the Brendan Fraser mummies, I love those movies. Those are top 2 and 3. Like I said, all the ones on my arms kind of have meaning and like almost like sentimental value. These are for myself, just for fun. And I feel like I'm gonna have some more fun with my legs. You're gonna see more random stuff on my legs eventually. It's gonna get to the point where it's just gonna be random all over my legs. I forget I have this. I have Villano tatted right here down my neck. I think it was my mom or someone told me, they're like, oh, don't you ever get your neck tatted. I said, okay, bet. So what did I do? I found a tattoo artist the next time I was home, and I was like, I want my neck tatted. Walked into the shop. He was like, oh, you want Vienna? I said, yeah, let's do it. He said, what kind of font? I said, have you ever seen the Spider-Man comic? He said, say no more. And it's funny too, because I'm sure I've said it before in the past. I have 6 godfathers, all luchadors, all of them. And one of them just happens to be Villano Cuarto. So you can say this is for one of my godfathers, and also I just enjoy being a villain.
I would say this guy right here is the one I get complimented the most on.
So I had this one done, the Cuestecal, and it's basically the Aztec dragon. And I love the way he did it on my hand and how it came up. So when he did this one, I told him, I was like, is there any way we could do like an Aztec god of some sorts? And he was like, yeah, Aztec god of war, which is him. And he goes, and we'll just create all the animals that are affiliated with him, which would be bats, spiders, jaguars, owls. So the fact that he was just kind of able to put it all together and make it into one like solid piece is really cool. I think this one gets complimented the most just because of how it all connects into one. If I had to take back one of them, we come from a Latino household, Mexican culture, and we have this card game. It's basically a Mexican bingo called La Lotería. And this guy just happens to be El Valiente, which means the valiant. But what I did was I changed it to El Misterio and turned it into a card. And then I put my dad's birth year on here. And this is Mr. Condor. He was the first guy that my dad ever demasked in Mexico. So I ended up putting his mask there as kind of like to him, you know? Yeah, when he finished, I was like, oh, we're too deep into this now. Like, there's no going back. But yeah, maybe one day I'll put like a different card of like, maybe I'll do like a Judgment Day card where we're all just like doing something, pointing down at him. The ribs were definitely one of the most painful. This one on the inside of my arm was not fun as well. He has one small line going inside of my armpit, and I told him to stop. Like, I was like, please stop. Like, you see all these tattoos on me, and you probably think, oh, he sits through these, no problem. This big, tough guy. I'm a big baby when it comes to needles. I can sit, and I have a high pain tolerance, but my goodness, there are certain areas that you just, like this guy. I was like, please, sir, just stop. But I would say that one, the ribs, the fingers weren't fun either. He surprised me because I went to go get my legs done. And he was like, hey, I'm going to give you a free tattoo for your birthday. What do you want? I was like, can you do Mysterio on my fingers? And he ended up doing that for free. Again, it was not fun, but it looks cool as hell. So that's, you know. And then a couple weeks ago as well, I got my calf done. It's a Dracula from Van Helsing. One of my favorite movies. It gets a bad rap for some reason, but it's probably top 5 for me. But
this guy right here, absolutely brutal. And I just feel like he was coloring book, just having fun on my leg. And I remember I looked at him and I said, how we looking? He goes, we're about 95% done. I said, I think we're done.
I got a couple of meaningful ones that I've gotten with the Judgment Day crew that are pretty special. Like this one, we did that in Puerto Rico, Judgment Day with a little bone, Puerto Rico. All of us, Rhea, Damien, and myself, Finn, I think Finn already had gone to bed, but we all wanted to get something because it was a really special night for I feel like for all of us. Last time I was in Puerto Rico before Backlash, I opened a live event with Jinder Mahal. And I remember I did something where I messed up. So going back this time around for SmackDown on Friday, being the main event with Rhea at the Coliseo de Puerto Rico, El Choli was it was unbelievable, man. So, and then that following night, Damian having match of the night against Bad Bunny, it was something genuinely special. And I feel like we had to do something to remember that moment forever. So we went ahead and got this done. My bond with the Judgment Day crew, I feel like, has taken on a life of its own that I never in a million years would have imagined I would have had a bond that I do with them like I do now. I literally have a scale tattooed on me right here for Judgment Day. And this one's actually even more special because not only is it a scale, but Rhea actually drew it. So she drew it and the tattoo artist ended up just tattooing that on us. And so like this is really special too, just to be able to have that, you know, crew's always with me. We literally ride together. We're always together. We're at the airports together. We travel together. We have our own Judgment Day group chat. We've literally become a family. It's kind of insane how it happened because never did I imagine that like this group of random people would get along so well, and it just clicked. And I'm very thankful to have them by my side. Actually, that's so funny. I have something, I already have something lined up for my legs. I wasn't a big reader as a kid. I didn't read a lot of books. I can say I've read probably 3 books cover to cover in my whole life, and I'm proud to say that. But I read a lot of comic books as a kid, one of them being Calvin and Hobbes. Freaking love Calvin and Hobbes. So I think what I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna start a comic strip of Calvin and Hobbes going across my legs, just maybe a couple here and there. I think eventually the goal is to just be covered up, you know? I don't know if I wanna go fully crazy on my neck, but I think I would definitely like to do something like, I've had the idea of having this Aztec calendar going into my chest and kind of leading up into my neck. Again, this is all long-term, hopefully down the line. And maybe even when I have a family and kids, God willing, I can, you know, tattoo them as well on me. But do it correctly, because my dad did it, and he messed up.